Hello, my dear friends. I welcome you to Father Bonnie Reflections. If you're here for the first time, I want to tell you that you're in the right place. You made a very powerful choice to stop by. And if you're coming back, so nice of you. You are very thoughtful. I welcome you again in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends, the reflection this weekend is on this topic, how not to be a foolish Christian. You will love this. Let me begin by asking this question. Can you recall doing anything recently or in the past for which you could boldly say that you were foolish? Personally, I recall running out of gas while returning from a funeral one rainy evening. I saw a gas station. However, I was hoping to stop at the next one, but I could not get anyone until my car got to a dead stop. I have to call roadside AAA, and a truck came and lifted me and my car to the next gas station, which was about 25 minutes away. I made a wrong choice, and I thought that was foolish. My dear friends, I've come to realize and understand that the world is a field of choice making, and we are as good or as bad as the choices we make in life. The gospel today from Matthew chapter 25 from verse 1 to 13 shows us this. Our Lord Jesus Christ continues with the parables of the kingdom, and today he gives the parable of the 10 virgins. 10 virgins were invited to a wedding, and they had to come with their lamps. And typical of the parables of our Lord Jesus Christ, he makes a distinction between the foolish ones and the wise ones. 5 were foolish, 5 were wise. And the distinction is based on the fact that the wise ones took extra oil in their flask, but the foolish one could not do that. They were all waiting for this unnamed bridegroom to come in so that the wedding feast would start. But naturally, they were tired, they were drowsy, and they slept off. At midnight, there was a call asking them to wake up because the bridegroom arrived, showed up. And when they woke up, they started to trim their lamps. But imagine what happened. Their oil was going down, but the wise ones had extra oil, so they had to do the top up. But the foolish ones had none. They were begging them to give them some, and they said, "We can't share with you, because that will be dangerous for us, because we both could run out of oil." And they advised them to go to the local sellers to buy some. A very good advice. And they went. But before they could come back, the wedding started and the door was shut. They were begging the bridegroom, who had now become the Lord, said, "Lord, Lord, open for us." And the bridegroom, who is now the Lord, says, "I do not know who you are." The door was shut and the case was closed. My dear friends, foolishness is often the outcome of a wrong decision. The opening story sees me driving past a real gas station while hoping to buy gas in an imaginary one. And we thought that was a wrong decision, and it was foolish. The book of Psalms says that a fool says in his heart, "There is no God." We see this in Psalm 14 verse 1 and also in Psalm 53 verse 1. Here we understand that most of the foolish things we do come from our defective thought patterns. We see this happening to the foolish virgins. They had the wrong thinking. They had the wrong thoughts. They made the wrong choice. That was why they were not able to take the extra oil for their lamps. But the wise virgins had the wise thinking. Their decision was right of taking an extra oil, not knowing when the bridegroom will show up, and also not knowing how long the wedding will last. My dear friends, the turning point of the narrative, the turning point of the parable, is the flask of oil. Now we look at these virgins. Why were they invited to this wedding? There were 10 of them. In biblical numerology, the number 10 shows completeness. Exodus chapter 20 tells us about the 10 commandments. We hear about many designations about 10 in the Gospels. However, they were invited to become light bearers in that wedding banquet. That was why they have to come with their lamps, and that was why they needed to have extra oil, because their function is to light up the wedding feast. And that was why the other ones, the wise ones, could not share their oil with the foolish ones, so that they would not run out of oil. They needed to have the oil burning throughout the wedding feast. So they were there to bring light. Now, what do you think made them, the foolish ones, to forget the extra oil? What do you think? It was presumption. Presumption is one of the deceptions of the mind that will make us make wrong decisions. These people were presuming that if they run out of oil, the other ones will help them. They were presuming also maybe that the bridegroom might show up in time, and the oil they had in their lamp will last throughout the time of the celebration. But they were proved wrong, because the bridegroom appeared late, and their mates were not able to share what they had with them. So they had to go and buy, but before they could come back, it was late. They were not prepared. My dear friends, remember that this is a kingdom parable. The flask of oil is not just about the physical oil that will make the lamp to start to continue burning. No, beyond that, the flask of oil represents those virtues we need in our lives, in our Christian journey, in our journey to God. The flask of oil represents the virtue of faith, the virtue of hope, the virtue of love. St. Paul will bring them together in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13, and will tell us that they are the three things that will endure forever, though the highest of them will be love. Do you notice that when these foolish virgins returned, the door could not be opened for them? You now see that the appellation, the designation, the title virgin does not change anything for them. Virginity without virtue is vanity. So it doesn't matter if we answer Christians. It doesn't matter if we go with the nomenclature Christians, if we are not living the Christian's life. It is essential for us as Christians to have the right oils that would lubricate our Christian life. It is not enough for us to go around in our abject and defective religiosity as Christians without having a spiritual impact in our lives. The foolish virgins were just there answering the name virgins, having their lamps. They were feeling entitled and they were so presumptuous. That was why they did not enter into that banquet. My dear friends, yes, we are Christians, but beyond that, there must be a practical realization, a practical demonstration of our Christian lives. There will be also for us to have to examine our priorities. We have to discard presumption. We have to run with new virtues. We also have to sustain our hope, faith, and love in God for us to make this journey to the end. It is important for us to make this introspection at this point in this reflection. Are you a foolish Christian or are you a wise Christian? It is important for us to understand where we are on this journey. Are we on the path of the wise or are we on the path of the foolish? We can become foolish when we become complacent, when we so much relax, thinking that a Christian life is just, being a Christian is enough for us to get to where we are. Many of us will be surprised at the end of the day. It is important for us to rise up. It's important for us to stand firm. It is important for us to have extra oil in our flask, to be ready at all times, so that when the Lord comes, we'll be ready to answer that call. Let us pray. God of infinite goodness and kindness, grant us the grace to reflect the life of the wise virgins, to be ready with our flask of oil, knowing that the journey might be long. Grant us the grace to be sustained by your power. May we walk on this tripod of faith, hope, and love, knowing that you will not abandon us even as we strive to enter the kingdom of heaven. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless you.